Salaam alaikum. This time around, our video isn't about microbiology or biostatistics. It's about another subject that many people find it to be a challenging one. It's my favorite. Today, inshallah, we'll be talking about an interesting topic in cardiology. We will discuss heart sounds. Without further delay, let's get into it. Heart sounds happen as a result of valve closure, namely atrial ventricular valves, mitral and tricuspid. And this gives us S1 sound. And then we have S2, which happens when the aortic and pulmonic valves close. So normally we have something like this. This is S1 and this is S2. The area between S1 and S2 is systole. In other words, when the AV valves close and pulmonic and aortic valves are open, it is systole, where the blood is being pumped out of the ventricles. Diastole, on the other hand, is defined by the relaxation of the ventricles. It happens between S2 and S1 when the AV valves are open and aortic and pulmonic valves are closed. Now that we have this basic understanding, we're good to proceed. Abnormal heart sounds can be either of an added sound, such as S3 or S4, or can happen in the form of murmurs. Murmurs can be either systolic or diastolic, whether they happen in systole or diastole. So now we will focus on visualizing added sounds and murmurs while showing them simultaneously on this beautiful illustration. To make it more interactive and fun, we will give you certain clues and we will wait for a couple of seconds after each sound for you to try to guess before we show the answer. Now, for you to know whether the murmur you are hearing is systolic or diastolic, time the sound you hear with the corrected upstroke. That is when you feel the pulse that corresponds to S1. If the murmur comes right after it, this is systolic murmur. If the murmur comes not with the upstroke, but after the second heart sound, which is S2, this is a diastolic murmur. Just try to look at the heart, how it's contracting and how the valves are closing in S1 and S2. And then with this beautiful illustration showing S1 and S2, while keeping in mind whatever happens between S1 and S2 is systole. Whatever happens between S2 and then the next S1, that is diastole. Another thing to keep in mind, since we have S1 and S2 are the normal heart sounds, we have added sounds such as S3 and S4. As the name implies, S3 comes right after S2. So if you have an added sound that comes just after S2, think about S3. If the added sound comes closer to S1, then that is S4. So let's imagine a patient has all of the S's, S1, 2, 3, 4, just for the sake of discussion. This is how it would look like. So as you can see, S1 and S2, that's the normal position. And then you'll have S3 just right after or very close to S2, whereas S4, it is closer to S1. And again, keep in your mind, if you're examining a patient in real life, it might be tricky at the beginning to appreciate what is S1, what is S2, and then more challenging to appreciate S3 and S4. But with time, you'll become more sensitive on detecting these added sounds. Now, from this point onward, you'll be listening to heart sounds along with some clues while showing you S1, S2, and this beautiful illustration depicting how valves would open and close. So let's get started. Mm. Lastly, we will look at some disorders that can result in heart murmurs. If you understand valvular disorders, you will get more than 90% of heart murmurs correctly. Patients can have valvular stenosis, aka narrowing, or valvular regurgitation, which refers to blood going opposite to the normal direction. Now, we can divide heart murmurs, as we've seen, to systolic and diastolic murmurs. To understand the disorder and the murmur that corresponds to it, we need to imagine blood flow through these valves. If we have stenosis in aortic or pulmonic valves, this should give us a systolic murmur, since blood normally passes through these valves in systole, whereas mitral and tricuspid stenosis would give us diastolic murmurs, again, since blood passes through these valves in diastole. For regurgitation, it is the exact opposite story. Normally, in diastole, aortic and pulmonic valves are closed. However, if one of these valves is regurgitant, then these patients would have a diastolic murmur. Likewise, mitral and tricuspid valves are normally closed in systole. However, if they are open in systole, then this is what we call as mitral or tricuspid regurgitation, and this would give us a systolic murmur. So systolic murmurs include aortic and pulmonic stenosis, mitral and tricuspid regurgitation, while diastolic murmurs include aortic and pulmonic regurgitation in addition to mitral and tricuspid stenosis. Of course, these are not the only disorders that can result in heart murmurs. You have other conditions such as atrial septal defect, ASD, ventricular septal defect, VSD, or patent ductus arteriosus, PDA, and all of these can result in heart murmurs. And with that, we conclude our video. We hope you found it beneficial. Please let us know what you think about our first video on cardiology and whether you like the idea or not. And as always, please do not forget to like, share, and subscribe to get our latest explanation. Until next time.